everyone, this is Swinthia212. I am just coming in really quick just to say hello. As you can see, my hair is done. It's in braids. My oldest daughter did my hair, so happy about that. It took her about 3 days to do, because we kept stopping, you know, and then, you know, she got the kids and stuff like that. So it took her about 3 days to do. I really like it. I'm going to be wearing protective styles throughout the summertime. Because it'll force me not to cut my hair. Because I was thinking about cutting my hair again. And I'm always cutting my hair. It's like every summer I cut my hair really, really short. But this time I figured that I'm going to try to see how full I can get my hair to be within these past 2 years. I just want to see how much my hair can grow within 2 years. So for the summertime, I'm just going to be rocking braids. I'll take these out and put some more back in. But this time, I think, because I'm used to, when I get my hair braided, I'm used to dealing with human hair because it's lighter. This synthetic hair is really, it's kind of heavy. So when I try to put it in a ponytail or something like that, it feels like a crane is on my neck or something. So, and they're pretty, they're really, really long, as you can see, like, they're really, really long. So yeah, she did a good job and I really like it. So, and what else is going on? Today is just a chill day. Everyone's in school. My daughter, she left out. So she had some business that she had to take care of. So I am the only one in the house, and that is like a rare thing for me to have the apartment to myself. So I'm really liking it. It's really, really quiet in here. I had some running around to do today, but my oldest son, I don't know why he keeps doing this. I know he doesn't intentionally mean to do it, but he would lock his door from the inside and then close it as he's coming out. I know he doesn't intentionally mean to do it because the keys to go to the lock, we don't have. So he keeps locking his door, and I have to keep trying to shimmy his door open. And with housing, if you damage their doors, they charge you like $100. So I didn't want to break the door down or take the door off the hinges or anything. So I had to call housing to put in a ticket. And when I called them, they said the 17th of this month. I'm like, so my son's supposed to go about a week and a half without getting in his room? That makes no sense. So I had to call downstairs to housing, because what they do now is, it used to be you call downstairs to housing and they'll come right up and fix whatever has to be fixed. But now you got to call Manhattan, you got to get a ticket number, then they got to place you in the computer and all this other kind of dumb crap that you have to do for them to fix something, which is crazy. Something as simple as opening up a door will take them like a week and a half to get here. I mean, that's crazy. So I had to call downstairs and tell the lady I did have a ticket number, but my son can't be locked out of his room for a week and a half. What sense does that make? So she sent someone up here to open up the door. So my son is like, oh, my bad. I'm sorry, mommy. And I'm pissed off because I'm texting him. He's in school and I'm texting him like, you keep doing this. And he's like, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I knew he didn't mean it, but I was pissed off. Like, really? And so what I did was I took the whole damn knob off the door. Okay? I took my handy-dandy screwdriver and took the whole thing off his door. So now you can't be locking yourself out your room. Okay? So I think that what I'm going to do is the knob that's on my door, I'm going to put on his door because it doesn't have a lock. And I'm going to use his because I could be able to lock my door when I'm in my room, because my kids always have the tendency to be busting in my room door. So everything is pretty good. The thing with the furniture guy, when they delivered my living room set and the guy was putting my living room set together, this couch here, see this couch, I don't know if y'all can see this couch here. If you lift this part of the couch, it's storage up underneath. So when the guy was putting it together, he cracked it. So I took a picture and texted to Anthony, the I think he's the owner of Empire Furniture. And, you know, he pretty much ignored me. And then when I texted him back, I was like, oh, so you must be egging me. He was like, no, just trying to figure out how I'm going to get it fixed. I'll be out there Thursday. Ciao. Thursday came and went. Okay, nothing. So I'm going to text him again today. But what I'm going to do probably is definitely Wednesday, get up early in the morning, take my butt down there. You know, you just don't want to be acting all ignorant and stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's just, it's no need for it. Because, you know, a lot of my friends was like, I ought to curse him out. But I'm like, no, that's just not the way you handle stuff. It's a time and a place for it. So I'm going to go down there Thursday and I'm going to speak to him like, you know, what's going on? You can either fix it or order me a whole new couch. That'll probably take like a whole year for him to deliver the damn thing to me the way he's been going. So he was supposed to throw in 2 free lamps for the tables, the night tables, and he ain't do that yet. And then he was supposed to give me a $200 gift certificate, because I wasn't going to take it. But everybody was like, no, take it, because my daughter Allie, because this is a sleeper bed over here, but I really don't want her on my couch. I was going to get her a roly-poly bed and a dresser, so I can use the $200 gift certificate from his store to do that. But I don't know. I'm going to text him and see. I'm going to text him again today, and I'm going to tell him I'll be down there Wednesday early in the morning. And what else is going on? It's not really much going on. It's been pretty quiet this week. Tomorrow, we're going to go food shopping tomorrow. I'll probably do a food haul tomorrow. Just, you know, showing what I got. The things that I normally eat, you know. I find myself now I can eat more. I eat more frequently, like 6 more meals a day. But lately, my eating habits has not been, they haven't been bad, but they haven't been good. Like, I've been eating, like I told you, I'm so in love with sunflower seeds. I can go through packs and packs of sunflower seeds a day. And I know that's not good, because, you know, the salt retains water and stuff like that. So, I need to get me a digital scale. The scale that I have now really sucks. It's one of those old-time scales. So I need to get a new scale. And my sister put in my resume to her job, which I am so excited about. I'm really looking. She actually gave it to the head boss. And my sister's been working at her job for 4 years. And all her evaluations have been 5. You know, that's 5-star evaluations. The nurses love her. Her co-workers love her. She's never once got written up or nothing like that. So her putting in a good word for me will be excellent. So I'm really excited about that. My sister job, I'm sorry, y'all. I know I'm messing with my hair, but my head, you know, when you first get your hair done, your scalp hurts. So for her to use her name to put in a reference for me will go a long way. So I'm really excited about that. And at my sister's job, you start out in the union. You make decent money. And it will only be on the weekends, which is good. Because when I start school, I don't want my work to interfere with my school. But you can work more hours if you want to work more hours. You know, you just, no, pick up more hours. But for the time being, I'll just do the weekends because I really do need to concentrate on trying to get into school next semester. So there's a lot of stuff that I have to do. I think that's it. Everything is really, really going well. I'm just enjoying this quiet time. I just can't tell y'all, like, usually when the kids are not here, you know, they're in school, like my oldest daughter is here. So it usually be me and her, but she went out to take care of some business, and I am loving it because it is quiet. And I wash clothes all weekend, so it's really not much for me to do. So, yeah. It's just quiet. Tomorrow, I got some running around to do. I'm trying to get my twin sister to come out here. I think spring break is from the 14th to the 23rd. I think the kids go back to school on 24th. I think. I'm not really sure. I have to look. I know the 14th is when they start their summer break for like a week. I think it's a week or two. Yes. A little over a week. I'm trying to get my twin sister out here. I have furniture in here now. So it'll be some place for her to sleep. Which is kind of cool. I miss my twin. I talked to her like 50 million times a day. Talking about, what you doing? Nothing. What you doing? Nothing. So, that's it. Looks like it's going to rain today. I love it when it rains. I really do. It's a calming feeling. I love it when it rains. But I think that's it. Y'all know I have a tendency to ramble. There's not much going on. Everything is going well. That's about it. Yeah. So I will talk to you all later. And Karen, sweetie, how you doing, sis? When I tell you Karen is such a freaking sweetheart. Oh, my gosh. I think of her as my little sister. She's such a sweetheart. But you said you're doing a Google Hangout today. I will be there bright and early with bells on. Okay. I just love my Google Hangout family. They are just the most amazing, awesome people. I'm telling you, we be in Hangout for hours, cracking up, laughing, and having a really, really, really good time. So, I hope to someday meet somebody from our group. That'll be wonderful. All right, I will talk to everybody later. Have a blessed and wonderful day. And like I said, say good morning to people. You know, say good morning, good afternoon, good evening with a smile. It would definitely make someone's day. So whenever you're watching this, at whatever time, good morning, good evening, good afternoon, and good night. So I'll talk to you all later. Bye.